bud. We're almost to the mountain and it's raining again. This is today's dog walk. Gonna be slippery, muddy, and crazy. Well, we finally made it, but there's still no sun. It's still raining. We're gonna go up in that mountain right there today. This is a nice short dog walk. And I got more notes too today. I might have to put my loincloth on and swing through the trees. Like Tarzan. The fastest way to the top of the mountain. They're up in the mountains again. Be careful, those yetis are big. You gotta hurry up. There they go. The yetis, they're looking down. They're coming. Ooh, they're circling all over the place. Be heading now. And that's where we're gonna meet the yetis again. So be careful. That's good, good. Stay that way. Good, you're learning. Car's coming. That's where we're gonna be heading. Right up on that rocks there, the big rocks. A lot of wind today, bud. Like a twister. Yesterday 72, today 22. It's crazy. What do you see out there? You really really focused. You're on something. You're in high alert. That's. For a while, and then we'll head up to the top of the mountain and try to catch a yeti. Today's a good day because it's gray, so they come out today. Especially when there's a lot of fog. They sneak up on people. So you got to be ready. You got to be in high alert today. They're not messing around, those yetis. All right, today what I'm going to do is, I kind of wrote it, finished my notes. So I think today I'm going to focus on reading the notes and let Bella have a little fun hiking around and stuff today. That's going to be like a fun day for her today. Maybe a couple little drills here and there, but basically just playtime today. And I had all my information that I kind of consolidated it into 6 pages. There's a lot of pretty cool stuff, and hopefully it stirs up enough interest that people actually seek out the information and gain knowledge, which is, yeah, you see it? No, it's a yeti. There, girl. What's going on, mama? You know, you're really focused today. Yeah, it's all gray and stuff. That's a good girl. Yeah, that a girly. Oh, it's raining again. Wow, it's coming down hard. You feel the rain, bud? Yeah, it's a lot of rain. Yeah, it's bad today. A lot of rain. No sun. And it's getting cold now. We're going to drop about 46 degrees. We're going to be cold today. That's when the yetis come out. I know you're looking now. They're circling now. They're circling. I hear that. I hear that. All right, what I'm going to try to do is read through these notes. If I can read my writing, because sometimes my writing is pretty bad. But I'll try to go through them the best I can. This is a lot of good information. Formal training is always what is needed. There are plenty of dog owners like Bella and I who have never been to a formal dog training class. So what are we doing right? We have taken the time, and I said time, because I spoke about this before, to be with our dogs and instruct them, teach them on a daily basis. And that's it. It all comes down to daily basis of training, daily activity, daily fun, daily dog drills. We have learned how to understand and to communicate with our dog from day one. And I had mentioned this once before. You need to plan ahead and map out how you wish to develop and educate, train your dog. These notes are just an overview of a lot of information I got from my dog training classes, books, DVDs. So I'm trying to condense my experience into these notes, but like anything else, you have to actually do the research yourself, read the books, study the DVDs, take some online classes, and you can get to this level too. Dogs need routine physical and mental exercise and plenty of playtime. And I give Bella playtime all the time. It's silly playtime, but she loves it. She loves it. I already mentioned love. So again, I repeat, love is our primary, all-important motivation. It is love for your dog that will help you to become a better teacher, trainer to your dog. Dog language is mostly non-verbal communication. We need to learn to speak to our dogs without speaking. For example, when you bond, learn about your dog, and let your dog learn about you, you develop a very special language. It's almost like you communicate on a psychic level with your dog, on an energetic and a subtle energy level. It's almost spiritual. The book by Monty Roberts, widely known as Horse Whisperer, has a book entitled The Man Who Listens to Horses. I would recommend reading this book because that would give you more understanding about that energy, that connection, that spiritual connection. If you want, if all you want is a quick fix, band-aid on any behavioral problems, so to speak, then dog training is not for you. It takes patience, time, repetition, becoming creative, love, bonding, and much, much more. Effective strategies and tactics that are positive to help your dog to get the message that you are trying to teach. Learn how to communicate with your dog from day one. Make that connection. Primary motivation. It is the love that will help you to work through the challenges of training. Dogs smell fear. That's an old saying, but in reality, they actually do. They also sense fear along with every other vibrational emotion we are emitting. Because we all speak the same language on the level of vibes, that's an old slang term. Light forces, energy, subtle energy, chi. So it's really important that you reach and understand that level. I recommend reading a book called The Biology of Belief by Bruce Lipton. I read it, it's fantastic. It'll give you a lot of detail into what I'm speaking about here, if you're interested. Because if you can reach that level and make that connection with your dog, it's almost magical. Because you can definitely understand each other on a level that's totally different than physical level. It's on an energetic level, a spiritual level. Dogs can read our mind, our vibes, without having to use words. The Secret Life of Plants, author Peter Tompkins, recounts how he hooks some plants up to a polygraph machine and discovers that plants register alarm when he has the intention, and this is what I'm saying, intention, of burning them with matches, fire. So they always speak about attention in Tai Chi and Kung Fu because that's the inner energy that you're giving off. That energy dogs can pick up better than we can. We can do also pick it up if we become spiritual or start to understand energy on that level. That's how you really truly bond with your dog. And that's enough of the notes for today. There'll be more in the future, but I recommend researching all this information and try to develop that kind of contact with your dog that's almost spiritual because it's going to be well worth it. Time. A lot of wind today. All my notes are blowing away. They're soaking wet from the rain.
You hear that? Pretty cool, man. Yeah. It's coming. It's raining again, bud. What happened to that sun? It's a play day for Bella. I'm not gonna put her through any drills today. She let her relax, have a good time, get some freedom. And I wanted to go over those notes. They're condensed from a lot of different videos and experience. Books, DVDs. Basically, you have to actually spend the time to research everything. You can't just really learn anything from an overview, but it should stir your interest enough that you will seek out the knowledge. And the knowledge is well worth it, especially Bruce Lipton. He'll open your eyes up a lot to the energies, the inner energy, the subtle energy, the life force energy. It's got all different kinds of names. In Kung Fu, we call it Qi energy. And Aikido is called Ki energy, but it's all the same thing. When you get that on that level, then you can communicate with your animals. And they can communicate with you. What do you see down there? Nothing? That's okay. I seen this particular kind of energy in my Aikido class. I seen a lady who was 87 years old flinging men around like toys by using Ki energy. My Kung Fu instructor, too, he just touched me one time. I was almost knocked out. So the power is for real. The inner energy is for real. And if you can get on that level or somewhere near that level, it's amazing because the animals understand that level. That's how they communicate with each other. That's kind of why that other book I was talking about, the Enlightened Dog Trainer book, makes sense. Because if you can reach that spiritual level, you'll communicate with your animals naturally. It's not going to be an effort anymore. It just happens naturally. And you're centered in the energy connection between you and the animal. It's almost psychic. It's powerful. I've seen a lot of this stuff with the Kung Fu instructors. They're so centered, and it's amazing. You can sense their energy. So the animals sense their energy all the time. All of our emotions and feelings are given out as vibrations, and they pick up real pretty today with the green here. And my dog's happy. She's got the whole place to herself today because no one's out here. What's going on? One. Yeah. Ooh, it just lights up. Not as bad as those Yetis. No, they're worse. Those things are deadly up in the mountain. Cold up in there. That's cold. You're sinking in the mud. That's way too cold, and it's a twister coming. It's a cyclone. For this cliff today, we're going to have to free climb it, though. You're better than me, so I'll be the one falling off, not you. Regarding my notes, though, where I was trying to read them, the wind was blowing so bad, it was raining so hard that they were soaking wet, blowing out of my hands, so I could get about only 90% down. But I read about 90% of them, so that's good. Still gives you a lot of insight and information. Hopefully people will seek it out now. But definitely really hard to read them today. This way. We climb up on the rocks, but they're going to be slippery. Yeah, when I was reading the notes, there was gusts of wind, 35, 40 miles an hour, plus the rain, and the temperatures are dropping pretty quick, so basically they were blown out of my hands. So I had to try to get through that pretty fast, so it was a little bit clumsy, but nevertheless, there's enough information that hopefully people seek it out. I think it's definitely going to be beneficial to dog training. I know it's working with Bella and I. Bella is really happy now. We're definitely bonded. Like I said in the beginning, she was really a challenge. She was totally insane, running away, biting, nipping, growling. I couldn't even get a head collar on her. I couldn't grab her head collar. She was definitely crazy. One time she ran down the middle of the highway. I thought she was going to get killed. So it took about 2 years of steady training to get her where she is now, but she's happy now. Let's take a look at her now. You're all wet. You went swimming? Oh, that's too much. Gonna have to get the blow dryer now. Make it up in between the rocks that way to the top. It's gonna be a little slippery today. Everything's muddy and wet, but might be kind of interesting. We could try that. That way we don't have to hike up the trail, or we can cut it in half. Save a lot of time. Dude, that's a log. I can't believe you're carrying that thing. It's about 50 pounds. That's a good girl. That's huge. Rattlesnake? It was killer bees from the jungle? I was swinging through the trees, so I was safe. You can't swing through the trees. I had my loincloth on. We ready? We gotta go back. I know it's a small one today. Where's your log? Ah, that a girl. Yeah, you got the log. You didn't forget that. Good girl. Yeah. Be careful. The subways that come around that turn. And they can't stop. They're pretty big. Pretty cloud formation up there, though. That's nice. I kind of like that. Yeah, it's a gray day. It's supposed to be sunny today. They got that wrong again. They said the rain would stop and the sun would come out, but who knows? No one knows what's going on anymore. That's our talking rock. That's the magic rock. That's where we go when we talk about the notes. It's kind of cool, though. Pretty pine tree there. Yeah, it's going to get cold again. I could tell by the sky. And the wind is really cold now. That sounds like a twister. That is definitely about 30, 40 miles an hour. Dr. Roskin. Bella got bit by a Yeti. She's bleeding, but I think we will be okay. Gotta stitch it up.